Project Economy is our promise to keep you informed about issues that impact your wallet. And tonight, police officers in Port St. Lucie jammed the city commission meeting. As Ted White explains live from Port St. Lucie, it was all to help save the jobs of their fellow brothers in blue. Ted?
Quite the sight tonight, as you saw hundreds of police officers inside the chambers with their families and friends. You also saw people outside the chambers, at least 100 more. Now, city leaders have the task of slashing hundreds of millions of dollars, rather, from the budget, and they have to do it quickly. But many here say the deeps come too cut, the cuts, rather, come too deep within the police department. Giselle Boras has been a Port St. Lucie police officer for close to 4 years now. The single mom of two became a cop after her husband was killed in a motorcycle crash.
It was kind of hard for me to make the decision to be a police officer because, you know, we're already a one-parent family as it is. But I do it because I love to do it.
But her future with the department is uncertain.
And I am one of the officers who received a letter of layoff.
Boras joined dozens of other officers and their families to send a message to the city council.
If you cripple this agency by losing 40 officers, 8 detectives, and eliminating the support programs, we will see a massive negative change in the city and its future.
If I am laid off this year, it'll be one less taxpayer in the city.
I come from New Orleans. It was the murder capital of the world when I lived there, and I don't want this city to turn into that. And I guarantee you this, it will.
City leaders say Port St. Lucie is facing a $10.5 million shortfall, and the police union hasn't brought enough to the table.
Unfortunately, we've not had any success at this point with the police unions, making some progress with the public employees union, and we hope to eventually get to the table where everybody can agree.
Boras says the 20% reduction in the police force would jeopardize safety in the city.
And as far as us truly being a safe city, they have no idea what's going on out there. I mean, it gets nasty.
The proposed cuts also worry her children.
It would be a shame to see all these cops getting let go because then the city wouldn't be that safe anymore.
I want to have a roof over my head and a bed and some food to eat.
Port St. Lucie's mayor says they do have some wiggle room to work something out with the police union, but time is running out. These layoffs could come in a matter of months. We're live in Port St. Lucie. Ted White, WPBF 25.